Hey everyone, today I'm going to install this very cheap NVMe PCIe adapter with this Crucial 4TB M.2 SSD. I bought this for about $7 from Amazon on Black Friday, and it works with PCIe 4, 8, and 16 slots. I don't know what my expectations are for this since it is so cheap, but I figured even if it lasts me just a couple of months, $7 isn't a big loss, and it's a good way for me to test one of these in my computer. So let's open this up, put this together, and install it in my computer. When I open the box, we have a few things here, including a Phillips head screwdriver, along with a screw and a spacer. Then we have the unit itself, the NVMe PCIe adapter. The heatsink is already installed, but I'll need to remove it in order to install the drive. It also comes with a few things of thermal paste for the M.2 drive. I think I'll skip adding this to the drive. Now I'll open the Crucial M.2 SSD from its shell, and it's super tiny. And it also includes a screw. Before I can install the drive, I need to remove one end of the heatsink so that I can put it to the side and install the drive. Next, I'm ready to take the drive out of its shell. And I have to comment that it blows my mind that we live in a time when something this tiny, the size of my finger, holds 4 TB of storage, and it's not even the smallest thing with the biggest storage out there today. Once I'm ready, I'll slide the drive in to the slot on the card, and then screw the drive in on the other end. Alright, feels pretty sturdy. Now I'll screw the other end of the heatsink back on, and then see how that looks. And now that looks and feels good. So now we're gonna open my computer and install this thing in one of my PCIe slots. All right, so I have my card here. It's going to go into one of my PCIe 16 slots. One is here a little bit. It's behind the power source, you can't really see it. And you can see that here, right here, there is another M.2 drive slot. I can't use it because the other hard drives I have installed in this are using up the PCIe bus, and I don't really want to start unplugging things, trying to figure out which one I would need to disconnect to free this slot up. So I'm just gonna, so this will install, and it should be a pretty easy install. I'm just gonna push this in here, and then we'll see, plug it back in and see how it works. So I'm just gonna do this. Apologies for blocking. There we go. It went in there, and it snapped into place. The clip here at the end snapped it into place. It is a little bit wobbly. Don't know if that's intended, but if anything happens, I have a third PCIe 16 slot. Again, let's see if I can get it into view. I'm adjusting my camera right there. Here it is. So I can plug it in there if this one doesn't work. So we'll see. This is a screenshot of my motherboard settings as detected by my BIOS, and you can see that it clearly detects my M.2 drive connected to this PCIe slot. Previously I mentioned that it was a PCIe 16 slot. I was wrong, it's a PCIe 8 slot according to this. I thought it was PCIe 16. But anyways, here I am on my computer. You can see my other drives that are connected. Most of these are four other drives in there. And we're going to initialize our a new drive, so I'm going to click on manage, right click manage, and then in the system tools click on storage, right, disk management. I could have just gone here, and it automatically asked me I must initialize logical disk, disk 3, GPT, yes, because it's I think master boot record has a 2 TB limit, and this is the disk here. Click on OK. So it has been initialized. So now I'll do a new simple volume. Click next. Yep, I'll take all of it. Now I need to assign a drive letter. All right, I'll click on M, and then I will call it Mercury. If you've noticed, a lot of my names are astronomy themed. So I think Mercury drive is good from a quick format. Click OK, click finish. And here's my Mercury drive, and it has opened in this window here. If I go back to my PC, my M drive is here, 3.63 TB, pretty good. I'll run Crystal Disk Mark here on the M drive and see what this looks like. Alrighty, this is completed, and as you can see, the read and write for the top sequencer is pretty good. And for this sequencer, it's actually better than I expected. And for 4 kilobytes, 43 and 91, it's pretty good. I'll run this on my C drive and compare it really quickly. But I'll mention that the Crucial P3 drive is rated for up to 3,500 megabytes per second, so this is getting 3,300, pretty good. The question for this setup is now, how long will my $7 adapter run? Like, even if I get like a year out of it, I'll call that a success. But if it stops running, I will post an update on this channel here. So I'm gonna run this one. I'm just gonna take a quick screenshot of this so we can compare. Alrighty, screenshotted. And then now I'll switch this to the C drive and let's run the exact same thing. All right, so this finished, and this is the C drive, which is the onboard M.2 drive. And if I bring the screenshot in, you can compare, and you can see that this drive is a little bit faster. It could also be that the hard drive itself, the M.2 drive itself, is newer. The results are comparable. This has been running for a while on board. This is new. And while running this, I also realized how far back I am in Crystal Disk marked versions. 5.1.2, you can see how long I've had it. Version 9 is apparently out as of last month. So I'll get that and run those again, but I don't expect these readings to be different. But if I do see differences, I will note that in the description. But these are readings using the Crucial M.2 SSD and my $7, I even forget the name of the brand, PCIe adapter for this drive, and I can install one more in my remaining PCIe slot, which is a times. So I've been using this for a few days now, and it's been pretty good. And I moved over a bunch of my files from my C drive into this new Mercury drive, and it's worked really well. And I'm really impressed with the transfer speeds that I've seen between the two drives. Here's a little screenshot of it going at 1.48 gigabytes per second. It did reach almost 2 gigabytes per second at one point, so it's pretty good. I'm very happy with it for now. If I notice any changes in performance or it just fails, I will update the description as well as the stickied comment in this video below, so check that out for updated information. And if you want a link to this product itself on Amazon, that link is in the description below as well. If you have any questions about anything I showed, or if I skipped over anything, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching.